So, welcome back to another episode. It's time to get these birds out for a fly. Same time, give this loft a little bit of a clean. It is 5:30 a.m. on a Sunday, and the weather conditions are absolutely ideal for getting these guys up. It is perfect ranging weather, and that's what I want them to do. I need to get them out as quick as possible. I need them to clear. The problem we had yesterday is that we get heaps want to rush out. They disappear instantly and head off ranging, and then a few that get stuck back don't really want to go anywhere and they want to just sort of stay around here. So the trick of today is to get them out as quick as possible and just see how they go. I am assuming they're going to range pretty well. So that is the plan anyway. That's a beautiful pigeon. That's Titan and Little Storm's first round, I think. I think it's the only blue bar they produce, and he's a little beautiful pigeon. He's the one that escaped and come back out. Or come back in really quickly, sorry. But he's ready to go. Look at him. He's all ready. Right, let's do this. Let's get you up in the air. Okay, they're all up, and I managed to get them up all out pretty quickly. We've still got one flock up a bit higher, and then there's one out here. Let's hopefully they join up and then they disappear. This is really good weather for it. I feel like these ones up here are going to range because they already sort of... Oh no, they turned back around. I think they want to join up with the other ones, which is really good. Good. Okay, yeah, they're all joining up now. This is really good. So hopefully they head off for a little bit of ranging action. That's what we need. I really like it when they fly up quite high like that. It's almost hard to see them, but they're there. This focus is not very good this morning. That's the majority of them in that little flock. And I'll say they're going to disappear very soon. And then looks like we've got four or five that are sort of doing their own thing. They're heading off over here. They're still up pretty high. It's really hard to see this morning. Okay, so it looks like those ones got left behind and then the others are gone. So there's five, they're still up quite high, so they still might range on themselves. But the rest of them, they're all gone. They're definitely out of sight now. I can't see them anywhere. I think they headed off out this way. So they've gone south. Have a little bit of a look out there. So yeah, I'll get in and give this loft a clean while we're waiting. We'll probably have one or two birds drop down because there is one there by itself. And those four now sort of, don't know how keen they are, but hopefully they do a little bit of ranging. We'll see who that first one is to come down. I probably think it's going to be the splits. But those four seem to be enjoying flying. The splits are, the first generation of splits are sort of slowly making some progress. Ooh, I still need to wake up a bit this morning. I don't want to go too hard on them because every time we do let them out, they are improving slowly. The fact that they're up here flying, we did hold them back for quite a while, so that is a little bit of a disadvantage for them. So that's kind of, that is my responsibility. So I'm going to give them a little bit more leeway for the time being. And hopefully, oh, this shock and this focus in this today. So we'll see who comes down anyway. I just feel like because we've held them back for so long, they might just need a little bit more time to strengthen their wings. All signs are indicating that all these birds are eager. That's just some parrots, they're not mine. But yeah, the indication is showing me that they are keen and they do want to fly. So we'll just see who's in this five here. because I'm assuming they will come down. They've all sort of split up now, all doing single flying, so we'll see who it is. So we got 9, I think, here. There's one still flapping around that are definitely not in that bunch of ranges. So we got like Beefcake, the Splits, and Thunder, which are all, the actual split cocks are older, Thunder's older. So I'm not sure whether these are going to take a lot more work or they're already spoiled, but I guess we can just keep trying. And then we've obviously got, I think it's other 9 to 10 that actually are out ranging still. It's been quite a while. So we've got 2 very different groups, and it's kind of split down the middle at the moment. We've obviously got this little group here, which is ridiculously blurry, that although they do want to fly, they're still quite a little bit lazy. And then we've got the other ones that just are total opposite, and they're just absolute flyers. So really need to sort of focus on sorting these birds out. Like, they're all right here. Now they're showing off fine. We just need to get them up in the air for longer periods of time. Well, now he's a flying better. I think they just get a little bit snaky and they think that I'm gone and they want to come down. Well, hopefully they go range, it might be nice. I'm coming back around. Some days they want to fly and some days they just want to be cheeky. But these ones seem to be going right now, which is just strange. They're just pigeons, eh? Right, it's time to come in. Come up. Mom. Mom. Come on. Oh, just hit the camera, you silly pigeon. Come on. Come on. All right, tray's down. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Thunder, stop trying to land on me. Just calm down a second. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, Beefcake and the Barless. Oh, come on. That's not how you get in the loft, is it? You're going to miss out on this little breakfast. Come on. Ah, I tell you what. Beefcake, he is such a character. He want to sort himself out. I'll go around this way. He's so cheeky. Now where are they going? Well, you're going to miss out because you're being silly. So we had a little bit of rain last night, so we got a little bit of dampness on here, which I'm not very impressed with. We're meant to be in summer, This will dry out pretty quick anyway. Our days are super hot, but the nights seem to be getting a little bit wet. We are in La Nina, I think it is, so we're getting a above average rainfall. We've pretty much done our record for the last 2 months straight, 30 year record or something. So I'm hoping it starts to slow down a little bit soon, just so that we can really sort of start figuring this loft out a bit better. But it's not really affecting the birds at all, it's just a little bit on the ground. But lucky I've got the structural ply anyway, so it's quite resilient to that. This morning, they still flew for probably about 30, 35 minutes, the main ranges, which isn't too bad. We are slowly getting there. There's still a couple of birds out, but they've been the naughty ones. So these guys are going to get all the food and the other ones can miss out. But yeah, we're slowly getting there, slowly, slowly. I know I've read a lot of comments there, and yeah, loft flying is pretty good, but the best training and best exercise and strengthening is when we start getting to the training tosses. So that is reassuring. I think by the time that comes around, it won't be any time in this year, it'll be sometime in early in the coming year, which is only about 6 weeks away anyway, so we'll probably look at like late January maybe before we start tossing most of these birds, which is not that far away really. It's probably like 8 weeks really that we'll probably start looking at that. That's why we'll fly pretty quick, and by then we'll have all the other young birds in here. We won't toss those, but they'll be learning with these guys. The fact that these guys trap pretty quick and they do it, you know, they come in when they're told generally, apart from Beefcake and the other hen, which is all pretty good, so definitely on the right track. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video. Stay tuned. Enjoy your weekend.